हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई पुष्पिंदर कौर वेलकम यू इन द फिफ्थ वीडियो लेक्चर बेस्ड ऑन यूनिट टू सॉल्यूशंस। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस एंड द नॉन आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस एंड डेविएशंस ऑफ द रियल सॉल्यूशंस फ्रॉम द रॉल्स लॉ। हेयर रियल सॉल्यूशंस आर ऑल्सो इन द कैटेगरी ऑफ द आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस। एज यू नो, we classify the binary solutions as the ideal solutions and the non-ideal solutions on the basis of intermolecular interactions between the solute particles and the solution particles. Let us suppose A is the solvent and B is the solute particles, and the interactions between the A solute are the AA interactions, and the interactions present between the B solute is the BB interactions. When you mix both A and B to make a binary solutions, the interactions present between the solutions are AB interactions. For the ideal solution, these AA interactions are equal to the BB interactions and these are equal to the AB interactions. But in case of non-ideal solutions, the AA interactions and BB interactions are not equal to the AB interactions. On the basis of interactions, we classify the non-ideal solutions into two categories. One is the solutions having positive deviation, and second one is the solutions showing the negative deviations. In case of the positive deviations, the AA interactions and BB interactions are stronger than the AB interactions. It means the interactions present between A and B in solution phase are weak in as comparison to the interactions present between the in the pure form. Or in case of the negative deviations, the interactions present between the solute particles and the solvent particles are less than the interactions present between the solution particles. It means in case of the solutions having the negative deviations, AB interactions are stronger than the interactions present in the solute and the solvent in the pure form. If these interactions are different in case of the non-ideal solutions, it means the vapor pressures present in the solution form is also different as comparison to the pure form, and we represent these positive and negative deviations with respect to the ideal solutions as in the first graph represent for the ideal solution, where P total is equal to the sum of the PA plus PB, and this graph showing the ideal behavior of the solutions. But in case of the positive deviations, when the interactions present between the solution particles are less than the interactions present in the solute and the solvent in the pure form, then the total pressure is greater than the actual pressure. Here the dotted line shows the ideal behavior and the dashed line shows the positive deviations, where the vapor pressure of the solution is greater than the actual pressure. In case of the negative deviations, where the interactions present between the solutions, means the interactions present between A, B particles are stronger. It means the vapor pressure is less than the total vapor pressure, and the graph is shown like this, and this graph is showing the negative deviations of the solutions. Let us discuss these solutions in details. In case of the positive deviations, the interactions in the solutions are less than the interactions present in the pure form. It means AB interactions are less than the AA interactions or the BB interactions. If the interactions are less, it means the AB particles easily escape from the solution as comparison to the pure form. If the particles easily escape from the surface, it means the vapor pressure of the components present in the solution phase are greater than the vapor pressure of the component in the pure form. Here PA is greater than the PA naught XA and PB is greater than the PB naught XB. It means P total is greater than the sum of the PA plus PB. In spite of these, the solution showing the positive deviations suffers from the following limitations. The first one is the P theoretical is less than the P observed, and the second one is the total volume of the mixture is always greater than the zero. It means if you mix 10 ml of the solute with the 10 ml of the solvent, the volume of the resultant solution is always greater than the 20 ml. This is due to the less force of attractions present between the AB particle as comparison to the AA and the BB. Most important, delta H mixing means the change in the energy is always greater than the zero in case of the positive deviations. Hence, the overall process is endothermic in nature. It means the amount of the energy released is incapable to break the interactions present between the AA particles and the BB particles. And the solubility of such solutions is increases with the increase in temperature. This is a graphical representation of the solution showing the positive deviations. The dotted line showing the ideal behavior and the dashed line is represent the positive deviations. In case of the solution having the positive deviations, P total is always greater than the sum of the PA plus PB. Few examples of the solution showing the positive deviations are ethanol and the cyclohexane, ethanol and the water, ethanol acetone, methanol water, carbon tetrachloride and benzene, carbon tetrachloride and the toluene, carbon tetrachloride and chloroform, carbon tetrachloride methanol, benzene and acetone, carbon disulfide and acetone, carbon disulfide and the acetaldehyde. Let us discuss one example in detail, and for the other example the reasons are almost same. We are taking the example of the ethanol and the cyclohexane. In case of the ethanol and the cyclohexane, in case of the ethanol, due to the presence of the strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding, the pure vapor pressure is stronger as comparison to the solution form. When the cyclohexane is mixed with the ethanol, it reduces the hydrogen bonding and the escaping tendency of the alcohol molecules will increase. Same in case of the cyclohexane, the van der Waal force of attractions are present, and due to the presence of ethyl alcohol molecules, when it mixes, the attractive forces will reduces and it will also escape out from the solutions easily, which leads to the positive deviations. The vapor pressure of the solution of ethanol and the cyclohexane is greater than the vapor pressure of the ethanol and the cyclohexane in the pure form. And in case of the negative deviation, AB interactions are stronger than the AA interactions and BB interactions, means the molecules of AB do not escape from the surface of the solutions easily due to the presence of strong intermolecular force of attractions. It means the vapor pressure in the solution phase is less than the pure form, and the P total is also less than the sum of the PA plus PB. There are the few limitations of the negative deviations from the Rawls law is P theoretical is always greater than the P observed, and delta V mixing is less than zero. It means the total volume of the resultant solution is less than the total volume of the solute plus the solvent. For example, if you mix 10 ml of the solute with the 10 ml of the solvent, then the volume of the solution is always less than the 20 ml due to the presence of strong intermolecular force of attractions in the solution phase. And in case of the solution showing the negative deviations, delta H mixing is less than 0. Less than 0 means the delta H having value negative and the solution showing the negative deviations are exothermic in nature, means the amount of energy released is capable to break the interactions present in AA and the BB. For such solutions, the solubility is decreases with the rise in temperature. Graphically, we represent the solution showing the negative deviations like this. In case of the solutions with the negative deviations, the P total is always less than the sum of the PA plus PB, and this can be shown by the dashed line with respect to the ideal behavior, which is shown by the dotted lines. Few examples of the non-ideal behavior are chloroform and the acetone, chloroform and the benzene, chloroform and the diethyl ether, chloroform and the nitric acid, carboxylic acid and the methanol, carboxylic acids and the aniline. Let us discuss again a one example, and the reasons for other examples is almost same. In case of the chloroform, the acetone, both acetone and the chloroform having weak intermolecular force of attractions present in the pure form. When acetone and the chloroform both are mixed with each other, they are capable to make hydrogen bond with each other. And due to the formation of hydrogen bonding, they have less tendency to escape out from the surface of the liquid as comparison to then when they are present alone in the pure form. Now we will study the another important topic, the constant boiling liquid mixtures or azeotropes. As we know, in case of the positive deviations and the negative deviations from the Rolle's law, the vapor pressure of the component present in the liquid mixtures is increases or the decreases as comparison to the ideal solutions. And due to the change in the vapor pressure, the boiling point of the solution is also increases or decreases. In case of the positive deviations, where the vapor pressure is increases, the boiling point is decreases. And in case of the negative deviations, the vapor pressure is decreases as the boiling point is increases. We know both boiling point and vapor pressures are inversely related to each other. If the vapor pressure is increases, the boiling point is decreases. And if the vapor pressure is decreases, the boiling point is ultimately increases. At a particular time, the mole fraction of the component present in the solution phase become equal to the mole fraction present in the vapor phase. It means the composition of the constituent in the liquid phase and the vapor phase will be same. For example, the binary solution having the two components A and B, the mole fraction of the component A in the solution phase is XA and in the vapor phase is YA. At a particular time, both XA become equal to the YA and XB is the mole fraction of the component B in the solution phase become equal to the mole fraction of the component B in the vapor phase. At this point, both the component present in the liquid mixture will boil at the same temperature without undergoing any change in the composition. It is not possible to separate these components of the liquid mixture by the fractional distillation, and this type of the liquid mixtures which boils at the same temperature without undergoing any change in the composition is known as the constant boiling mixtures or the azeotropic mixtures. The azeotropic mixtures cannot be separated by the simple fractional distillation because there is a no change in the composition of these mixtures on the boiling. There are the two types of the azeotropes. One is the minimum boiling azeotropes and second one is the maximum boiling azeotropes. The minimum boiling azeotropes are those azeotropes whose boiling point is lower than the boiling point of its constituents. And this type of the azeotropes are formed in case of the positive deviations. And the maximum boiling azeotropes are those azeotropes whose boiling point is higher than the boiling point of its particles. And this type of the azeotropes formed by the solution which shows the negative deviations from the ideal solutions. Let us discuss these azeotropes in the details. Firstly, we will discuss the minimum boiling azeotropes. In case of the positive deviations, the boiling point of the solution is greater than the ideal solutions. We correlate it with the boiling points. If the vapor pressure is greater, then the boiling point is minimum. It means you have to provide the less heat to boil this mixture. Let us take the mixture of 95% of ethanol in water, and we are showing the temperature on the y-axis and the percentage or the composition on the x-axis. The boiling point of the ethanol is 78.5 degrees Celsius and the boiling point of the water is 100 degrees Celsius. What happens in case of the minimum boiling azeotropes? A one composition is reached when the composition of both in the liquid form and in the vapor phase become equal. Let us say this is the point where the composition of the both liquid phase and the vapor phase become equal, and at this point the mixture of ethanol and water start boiling, and the boiling point of this mixture is less than the both the boiling point of the ethanol and the water, and this point is known as a minimum boiling point. Next is the maximum boiling azeotropes. Maximum boiling azeotropes showing by the mixtures which having the negative deviations means whose boiling point is less than the normal ideal solutions. If the vapor pressure is less, it means the mixture boils at the higher temperature. Such liquid mixtures are known as the maximum boiling azeotropes. For example, if you take the mixture of 20.2% of nitric acid and the 79.8% of the water and it boils at the temperature of 120 degrees Celsius, which is greater than the normal boiling point of the water and the nitric acid. The boiling point of the nitric acid is 86 degrees Celsius and the boiling point of the water is 100 degrees Celsius. But the mixture of 20.2% of nitric acid and 79.8% of water boils at the 120 degrees Celsius. And this point represents the point where the composition of both water and nitric acid in liquid phase and the vapor phase become equal to each other. Let us solve this numerical based on the Rolle's law. In this numerical, we have to calculate the composition of the mixture in the liquid form. Here the vapor pressure of the pure liquid A and B are given as 450 and 700 mm of the mercury, and the total vapor pressure of the mixture is 600 mm of the mercury. We have to find the composition of this mixture in the vapor phase. In the vapor phase means we have to find the value of YA and the YB. This is the solution of numerical. The value of PA0 and PB0 and P total is given to us. We have to find the value of XA and XB, where XA and the XB are the composition of the mixture in the liquid form. According to the Rolle's law, P total that is equal to the PA naught plus PB naught minus PA naught into XB. Put the value of P total, PA naught and PB naught. When we put the value of these, P total, PA naught and PB naught, then we will get the value of XB. And we know that XA plus XB is equal to the 1. And XA is equal to the 1 minus XB. By putting the value of XB, we will get the value of XA. Now, in the second part, we have to calculate the mole fraction in the vapor phase. And we know that YA is equal to the PA over the P total. And YB is equal to the PB over P total. Now we require the value of PA and PB. We will calculate the value of PA by the Rolle's law. PA is equal to the PA naught XA. P naught A value we have 450 and XA we calculated here. Put this value, we will get the value of PA is 180 mm of mercury. Similarly, we can calculate the value of PB. The value of PB is PB naught XA. PB value is 700 mm of the mercury and XB value is 0.6. And we will get the value of PB is 420 mm of the mercury. Now put the value of PA and PB in this formulas and we will get the value of YA and YB. From the result, we can easily judge the Y is more volatile than A as the vapors of B is more than the vapors of the A, and as the value of P total is less than the value of PA plus PB, it means this mixture showing the negative deviations from the ideal solutions. Thank you.